Welcome to the video. If you haven't learned the basics of Vedic astrology, please visit the link below in the description box to see the two videos. Learn Vedic astrology in one day, part 1 and part 2. Now let's look at the Vimshottari dasha system. The most commonly used dasha system is Vimshottari dasha system. This is the most popularly used planetary period in which a planet controls a man's life for a certain number of years. The sequence and duration of planetary periods in the Vimshottari dasha system is fixed. In the Vimshottari dasha system, the first dasha depends on the planetary owner of the nakshatra through which the moon is passing at the time of birth. Now let's look at which planet controls which nakshatra. Ketu owns Ashwini, Magha and Moola. People born in Ashwini, Magha and Moola nakshatras have Ketu dasha as the first dasha. It is up to 7 years. Venus owns Bharani, Purva Palguni and Purva Ashada nakshatras. Venus dasha would be the first dasha for the people born in Bharani, Purva Palguni and Purva Ashada nakshatras, and it will be up to 20 years. Sun owns 3 nakshatras, Kritika, Uttara Falguni and Uttara Ashada. Sun dasha will be the first dasha of all the people who are born in Kritika, Uttara Falguni and Uttara Ashada nakshatras, and its span would be up to 6 years. Moon owns 3 nakshatras, Rohini, Hasta and Shravan. Moon dasha would be the first dasha for all people who are born in the 3 nakshatras, Rohini, Hasta and Shravan. And moon dasha would be up to 10 years. Planet Mars owns 3 nakshatras, Mrigshira, Chitra and Dhanishta. Mars dasha would be the first dasha for all people born in the 3 nakshatras, Mrigshira, Chitra and Dhanishta. Mars dasha would be up to 7 years. Rahu owns 3 nakshatras, Ardra, Swati and Satabisha. Rahu dasha would be the first dasha for all people born in the 3 nakshatras, Ardra, Swati and Satabisha. And Rahu dasha would be up to 18 years. Planet Jupiter owns 3 nakshatras, Punarvasu, Vishakha and Purva Bhadrapada. Jupiter dasha would be the first dasha for all people who are born in these 3 nakshatras, Punarvasu, Vishakha and Purva Bhadrapada. Jupiter dasha would be up to 16 years. Planet Saturn owns 3 nakshatras, Pushya, Anuradha and Uttara Bhadrapada. Saturn dasha would be the first dasha for all people who are born in the 3 nakshatras, Pushya, Anuradha and Uttara Bhadrapada. Saturn dasha would be up to 19 years. Planet Mercury owns 3 nakshatras, Ashlesha, Jyeshta and Revati. Mercury dasha would be up to 17 years. Now we will look at the sequence of the Vimshottari dasha system. For a person born in Ashwini nakshatra, the first dasha would be Ketu dasha. Then the second dasha would be Venus dasha. Third would be Sun dasha. Fourth would be Moon dasha, followed by Mars dasha, followed by Rahu dasha, followed by Jupiter dasha, followed by Saturn dasha, followed by Mercury dasha. And if the person is still alive, Mercury dasha would be followed by Ketu dasha again. This sequence goes on like a cycle as long as the person is alive. Now let's take another example. For a person born in Pushya nakshatra, Saturn dasha would be the first dasha. And then Mercury dasha would be the second dasha. Then for the third dasha, Mercury dasha would be followed by the Ketu dasha. So this is how the sequence gets repeated again and again, as long as the person is alive. But generally, a person doesn't live up to 120 years. Now, let's look at another important thing. Vast majority of people don't have the first dasha for the full duration. Remember, this rule applies only for the first dasha. The duration of the first dasha is dependent on the moon's position. The duration of the first dasha depends on how much percentage of the nakshatra length which the moon is yet to cross. Here, in this example, let's assume the moon is crossing from second pada to third pada when the person is born. Now the moon is in halfway mark in middle of Ashwini nakshatra. Now, moon has 50% of the Ashwini nakshatra length remaining in front of it, which it is yet to cross. For a child who is born at this moment, the first dasha would be Ketu dasha, because Ashwini is a nakshatra owned by Ketu. Now the first dasha is Ketu dasha, and its duration will be only 50% of the total Ketu dasha span of 7 years. So, the child who is born at this moment will have only 3.5 years of Ketu dasha as the first dasha. Now, let's look at another example. Here, in this example, let's assume that the person is born when the moon is crossing over from 3rd pada of Bharani nakshatra to the 4th pada. At this point, moon has already crossed 75% of the Bharani nakshatra length, and 25% of the length is still remaining to be crossed. For a child born at this moment, the first dasha would be Venus dasha, because Bharani nakshatra is owned by Venus. The total span of Venus dasha is 20 years. But here, for the child born at this moment, the first dasha duration would be only 25% of the total 20 years, which means the first dasha would be only for 5 years. In this example, the first dasha is Venus dasha, which is for first 5 years. Now it is followed by full dashas of other planets. The dasha predictions are based on so many factors. First one is the dasha or planet's house position in the chart. A planet which is running a dasha will give the effect of the house in which it is positioned in the chart. For example, if the planet running your dasha is placed in the 6th house in the chart, it will give you the effect of the 6th house. It can cause you diseases. It can trap you in debt. It can cause obstacles. It can cause fights and legal disputes. The next thing to remember is that the planet running the dasha can give you the effect of the house over which it has lordship. For example, if the third lord is running your dasha, it can give you the effects related to the third house. The next thing to remember is this: a planet running the dasha can give you the effects of its natural kargatvas, the natural significations. For example, Venus is a natural significator of love and marriage. It can cause marriage for most people, irrespective of its position in the chart. Similarly, Saturn is a natural significator of sorrow. It can give you suffering during the Saturn dasha, irrespective of its position in the chart. At same time, Saturn is a natural significator of job and career. So, Saturn can give you job during its dasha. Another thing that decides the effect of a dasha running planet is its strength. Whether a planet is strong or weak decides whether it is going to be positive or negative. You should also look at the Navamsha position of the planet which is running the dasha. And you should also consider the nakshatra lord where the planet is placed. The planets related to 6th house, 8th house and 12th house gives difficulties during the dashas, because 6th house is related to diseases, debt and disputes. 8th house gives sudden ups and downs in life, unexpected events, accidents and humiliation. 12th house gives loss. The planets related to 3rd house and 11th house can also give difficulties during the dashas, because third house is 8th to 8th house, and 11th house is 6th house to 6th house. I hope this video helps in understanding the Vimshottari Dasha system. Please put likes and subscribe to my channel for further videos.